저는 지난번에 아이압의 마이크 미클 목사님을 통해서 아이압이 어떻게 기도를 하고 있는지, 특히 또 아이압의 이스라엘 위한 중보기도 모임이 있다라는 이야기를 들었습니다. 그래서 오늘은 아이압 이스라엘 중보기도 모임의 총괄 책임자이신 조한 지첨 목사님을 오늘 또 이렇게 찾아뵙고 이야기를 나누도록 하겠습니다. 목사님, 이렇게 시간 내주셔서 고맙습니다.
Nice to meet you as well.
우선 본인 소개를 좀, 그리고 아이압에서 어떤 일들을 하는지 좀 자세하게 좀 설명을 해주시죠.
About 3 years ago, just felt like the Lord wanted us to move here to become part of all that the International House of Prayer is doing. We've been helping from a distance. And so as I've come, they put me in charge of community life. So I am over all the friendship groups. We have about 200 friendship groups here. And I oversee pastoral support, all the counseling and inner healing ministries. I oversee all the prophetic teams. I oversee the healing teams. I oversee the deliverance teams. And so for the last 3 years, I've been doing that role. But all that while, I mean, I'm sure we're going to get into some of my story about a heart for Israel. I've been carrying that. And I just really feel like, and the leadership team is in agreement, that it's time for me to step into, ultimately, this is what I believe is the call on my life, is to stand with Israel and to try and rally the church into the Lord's purpose and heart for Israel. And so I think that time is now.
그럼 이 아이압에서는 그럼 이스라엘 위해서 어떤 기도를 어떻게 지금 하고 있습니까?
So we have been, since 1999, we have been praying day and night. And so Mike Bickle really received, you know, a mandate from the Lord as it relates to 24/7 prayer, day and night prayer. And so he had been pastoring a congregation. He laid that down, started the prayer room, because the Lord very specifically told him, this is what I want you to do. And he did that through a series of really prophetic encounters and dreams. And there's a gentleman by the name of Bob Jones, very strong prophetic man, that had a very significant role in helping Mike understand that this is what God wants. He wants a prayer room. He wants the church to re-find its roots in the house of prayer. My house is a house of prayer. And so Mike did, starting in 1999, Mike did that. And that time and season, it was also very understood that one of the main reasons for this prayer room, for this prayer movement, was to pray for Israel, to pray for the fullness of God's plan to bring Israel back, into relationship with Him. And so we're going to learn how to pray for them. We're going to learn how to stand with them. We're going to learn how to receive His heart for Israel.
마이클 비클 목사님께서 이 아이압 안에서 이스라엘에서 기도하는 그 기도팀, 이것을 우리 전 목사님한테 특별히 다 맡기셨어요. 전 목사님은 어떻게 이스라엘을 품게 되셨습니까?
I grew up in a Catholic family, but really came to salvation understanding in a Reformed church. And so I really learned my Bible with the Reformed theology. And in a Reformed theology, there's not much place for Israel, that, you know, God's people is the church now, and Israel more relates to the Old Testament and the old stories. And so that was my understanding. As I started pastoring in the Vineyard, they didn't really have a theology for Israel as well. It was when I started a relationship with this prophetic man, Bob Jones. He had a real strong heart for Israel and would talk about that a lot. And one day we were talking on the phone, and he had had an encounter in the evening with an angel in his night visions. And the angel was dressed in a Russian army outfit. And the angel came and said, I'm a recruiting officer because there's an army being raised up in Russia that's going to touch the ends of the earth. And Bob Jones, you have a part in this. You have a role in this. And so he was sharing this story with me, and my heart came alive. And I knew there was something about this encounter that he had that was meaningful for me. And so that night before I went to bed, I'm praying with my wife about, Lord, I'm stirred about what Bob Jones said about that God's going to raise up an army in Russia. I think there's a part for me in this. And so we prayed that night. I go to bed, and I have a very powerful dream. And in the dream, I am with a couple named Avner and Rachel Bosky. And we are deep, intimate friends. And we're in Israel. And we're strategizing getting Jews and resources out of Russia into Israel and things in Israel back to Russia. And there's this divine connection between Israel and Russia. And I'm at this dinner table and we're deep, deep friends. Now in the natural, I don't know who Avner and Rachel Bosky are. I had been at a conference one time in Kansas City in which Avner had performed a song. So I knew he was a musician, but I didn't know anything else about his life. And that it wasn't just a dream. There was something special about it. When I woke up, it was incredibly vivid. I wanted to go back into the dream because the presence of the Lord was in the dream. And I knew it was really, really important. And so I didn't know what to do with that dream because I didn't know who Avner and Rachel Bosky were. But again, I just knew that the Lord had me on a journey about this is important. Again, this is a couple of months later. I'm talking with Bob Jones on the phone again. And he's telling a story about he had ministered to somebody who had gone over to Russia and had done a festival to celebrate Jewish heritage. And they were doing it in some of the major cities in Eastern Europe, in the former Soviet Union. And so this man had gone, and Bob Jones had prophesied to him that when he goes, his life would forever change because of the events that happened in this. And this guy's name was Avner Bosky. And so I say, Bob, I had a dream about Avner. And Bob says, well, that dream's the Lord. Like, that's a really important dream. You need to reach out to Avner Bosky. You need to call him. And I said, Bob, I don't know who Avner is. Like, I'm not going to call him because of a dream. And Bob's going, no, you need to. And I said, okay, thank you, Bob. And I hang up. The interesting part is that man, Avner, had gone to St. Petersburg and had gone to some of the cities. And he presented, they had this celebration of Jewish culture because the wall had come down. This is the early 90s. And then they gathered all the Jewish people together, celebrated Jewish culture and heritage, and then invited them to a stadium. And they presented Yeshua as the Messiah. And Avner had made a presentation. There's about 10,000 people that are there. And Avner had made a presentation about Yeshua being the Messiah, the fulfillment of all of Jewish heritage and culture. And many, many thousand Jewish people came to faith at that conference. And he was amazed and just dumbfounded. And so it really did dramatically change his life. And so the very next day, I get a phone call, and it's Avner Bosky calling me because Bob Jones had called him. And Avner said, listen, you have my attention. Your dream is very significant to me because Bob had shared the dream with him, and that's the call in my life, as I believe one day I'll be in Israel leading a messianic community that will have a heart for Russia because I've been profoundly touched in relating to what's going on in Russia. And so he said, your dream's very meaningful to me. You and me should meet. And so it was many months later, I met Avner and Rachel. And Avner is a leader in the messianic movement. He's a Jewish believer. He is very, very well studied. He's a scholar, really. And so we started relating. And probably one of the most meaningful interactions was we drove from Nashville, Tennessee, to Carolina, where Bob Jones was, because we were both friends with Bob. So we drove, and that's like a 8-hour, 10-hour drive. And in that time, we spent time together, and we stopped for lunch, and we were talking, and it was the first time that Avner really started sharing about Israel, about his understanding of God's heart for Israel, God's purposes for Israel. And I remember I raised my voice and I said, Avner, you believe what? You believe all those things? And I was like, I just didn't get it. And he said, you know, please don't raise your voice, it's okay. But he just kept talking with me, and then all of a sudden it just came alive. You know, you're looking at the scriptures, it's like, what are you talking about, Avner? Like, I understand the scriptures and I don't see Israel, you know? But all of a sudden, once it goes on, like, Israel's everywhere in the scriptures. Israel's everywhere in the Old Testament. Israel's even everywhere in the New Testament. And once that paradigm shifted, my heart came alive, and I've been on that journey really for the last 15 years or so, better understanding God's heart for Israel, because I want to embrace His heart.
이스라엘도 가보셨어요?
I have been to Israel twice.
어떠셨어요?
Transformational, in many levels. The first level is, there's something about being in the land and visiting the places that the scriptures come alive in a way that, so when you're at the Sea of Galilee, when you're walking around Jerusalem, when you're just in various places, like it all becomes so much more real, alive, concrete. So I just found that incredible. And then I visited with some of the messianic leaders in the land, And just my heart went out to them about how difficult their life is because of all the dynamics in Israel. And so for those two reasons, it was very profound.
메시아닉주들하고 이렇게 대화를 해보니까 어때요?
It was powerful. I had very little understanding of just the challenges of their life. You know, Israel as a nation is surrounded by enemies under constant pressure because of that. But then you have the Messianic community who not only has to deal with that dynamic, but then the people within Israel, their own people, have great pressure against him. So, you know, the bulk of the Jewish community doesn't embrace the Messianic movement, doesn't appreciate them, sees them as outsiders. And so they get much pressure because of that, as well as the pressure of just being in Israel. So their lives are very hard. And so my heart really went out to them. The Lord wants us to stand. And so we want to pray for God's protection for Israel. We want to pray for the Jewish people. We want to pray for the Messianic community. A lot of our prayers are very focused at the remnant believers in the land because they're very important to God's unfolding plan. And they're very important to us because we have a relationship with them. We know them by name. We pray for them by name. And so we're called to stand with them and we're called to stand with Israel. You know, right now, especially in America, especially in the American universities, the BDS movement, boycott and sanctions and to divest, that movement is taking ground. It's getting momentum. And so we pray against that. It's wrong. I believe it's a demonic strategy that we need to stand against. And so the power of prayer to turn that, we're very focused on that.
이스라엘을 위해서 기도하고 이스라엘을 축복하면 하나님께서 복을 주신다고 했지만 이스라엘을 위해서 기도할 때 또 그만큼 그 사탄의 공격도 좀 심할 것 같아요. 그런 경험을 하시지 않았습니까?
There's something about the way the Lord leads His people that Jesus is not afraid of controversy. And sometimes He leads us to places in which there's much controversy and there's much resistance. He didn't tell us it would be easy. In fact, He told us it's going to be difficult at times. He said, I'm not going to make it easy. I just promise you, I'll never leave you or forsake you. But He's asking us to step into difficult places. And I think the controversy around Israel is going to intensify dramatically. And so, yes, we get resistance as we stand. As a ministry and as a movement we do, and even individually. There's a cost to standing up right now in America, in today's society, and say, hey, I stand with Israel. There's pressure against that. And so you feel that pressure. You feel rage even sometimes. And yet, you know what? God told us that was going to happen. I'm not going to back away from that. I want to be strong in my inner man, and I want to strong up. And it's not just with Israel. It relates to if we believe the Bible, there's resistance right now coming against us in many facets. The definition of marriage, definition of sexuality. But I believe the Israel controversy is going to become much larger than all of them. It's going to cost us to stand with Israel. And the Lord's got plans and purposes in that. He's going to refine us even in that. I know as I have done that, I've had to learn how to manage my heart when people don't like me, when there's resistance, when I feel the rage of Satan. And the Lord strengthened me in that. What the enemy means for evil, the Lord takes and makes it for good. And I think the church is going to get purified as we say yes to God and His purposes. And good things are going to come out of that, although it won't be easy.
한국에서도 이스라엘 위해서 기도하는 분들이 많이 있고요. 또 이스라엘 선교 전문 방송 브레드 TV가 있습니다. 한국의 크리스천들에게 이스라엘 위해서 어떻게 기도해 주십시오? 혹시 이야기하고 싶은 게 있습니까?
We need to pray for Israel because the Lord tells us to pray for Israel. You know, the part of the call upon the Gentile church is that in our lifestyle and in all that we do, that we would provoke Israel, that the Lord has a covenant with them and the Lord wants to have them come into the full relationship with Him. And we're playing a role in that. But the truth is, there's a larger dynamic in that I really believe that we're not just praying for them, we need to be praying for them for us. There's something about when they get in their rightful place that the church is just going to come into its rightful place. You know, right now there's a video that our Marines use as a recruiting video, and it shows a whole bunch of soldiers, and there's about 12 soldiers, and there's a 12-foot wall, and the soldiers have to get over that wall but there's no ladder, there's no anything. And so a couple of the soldiers run and they get on the ground and the other soldiers step on top of them and then the other soldiers get up and over. And I think that's a little bit about what we're called to do, is we're called to lay down our lives so that Israel would ultimately step on us to get into its rightful place. But the end of that story is, as those soldiers go over the wall, they then reach back and grab onto the other soldiers and pull them over the wall. That the Lord is not coming back, and I really want him to come back. The Messiah really is going to come back to restore all things, and I really want that. He really wants that. He's the sovereign king of all of history. He's the king of the earth. He's king of heaven. And so I really want him to come back. But he's not coming back until Israel is in its rightful place. And so I'm going to do everything I can to cooperate with him, that Israel would find its place in him. And when that happens, boom, we all get pulled over to the other side, and that the restoration of all things begins. And so it's for both of us.
전 목사님의 귀한 간증, 그리고 이스라엘을 향한 그 사랑의 마음 믿으셔서 고맙습니다. 감사합니다.